A man in his mid-50s has 2 years of exertional dyspnea and neck fullness without any other significant past medical history. On physical examination, he has jugular venous pulsations while sitting upright at 90 degrees, as shown here in this video. And an enlarged pulsating liver with smooth edges palpable 4 centimeters below the costal margin. Auscultatory findings at the left lower sternal border show a normal S1 and S2 with a diastolic sound and no murmurs. An electrocardiogram shows sinus rhythm, rightward axis, and inferolateral T-wave inversions. PA and lateral chest x-rays show normal heart size and clear lungs. A transthoracic echocardiogram shows normal left ventricular size and function without valvular abnormalities. Based on these clinical and echocardiographic findings, what would you do next? A. Transesophageal echocardiogram. B. Right and left heart catheterization. C. MRI scan with gadolinium enhancement. Or D. Liver biopsy. The answer is B, right and left heart catheterization. The patient is presenting with classic clinical findings of calcific constrictive pericarditis. The jugular venous pressure is elevated to 20 centimeters of water with prominent X and Y descents. This contour distinguishes constriction from other conditions that can present with subacute dyspnea on exertion and cause jugular venous pulsation, like pulmonary hypertension, characterized by prominent A waves, tricuspid regurgitation, characterized by giant C to D wave, and restrictive cardiomyopathy, characterized by blunted X descent. The high-pitched early diastolic sound on auscultation is a prominent pericardial knock. The high-pitch frequency distinguishes it from a third heart sound, which is more subtle, low pitch, and occurs earlier. The pericardial knock results from sudden cessation of rapid ventricular filling due to pericardial constraint and coincides with the Y descent on jugular venous contour and the rapid diastolic filling wave in the ventricular tracing. Also, careful observers would have already noted the pericardial calcification on lateral chest X-ray. Cardiac catheterization is often required for definitive diagnosis of constrictive pericarditis. Pressure tracings showed early rapid filling, elevation and end equalization of left and right ventricular diastolic pressures, as well as enhanced ventricular interaction. This coronary angiogram provided additional findings of dense pericardial calcification and distal fixation of the coronary arteries. Constrictive pericarditis is a potentially curable etiology of heart failure. It's caused by inelasticity of the pericardium, resulting in restraint of ventricular filling. In the developed world, the most common etiologies of constrictive pericarditis are radiation treatment, prior cardiac surgery, and prior acute pericarditis. Many cases are idiopathic. Treatment is surgical, with radical pericardiectomy resecting the entire parietal and visceral pericardium from phrenic nerve to phrenic nerve. For a more in-depth discussion of the diagnosis, read the full clinical challenge online.